One of my popular topics for my seminars and workshops is called How to Press Play When You're Stuck on Pause.
Right.
It's a long title, but people just get it, you know, like corporations, whatever.
Well, that's a very good title.
It's playful.
Yeah, and that's you have a few different seminars. You do seminars and keynotes
as well,
right?
Yep, it's a dream come true to be able to travel and share my knowledge. And you know, just seeing people when I'm in, like, you know, the workplace and I'm speaking to an audience, and I can just see. I see the pain. I identify it. Like, they're either having problems with coworkers or they're afraid for their job. And by the end of it, I've given them really simple tools for them to apply instantaneously to stay positive. I mean, I would have to say that the number one thing that I love helping people do is build an optimistic mindset.
Right. Do you have a, if people are, let's say, who are getting, let's say, laid off right now
in
the workplace, do you have a seminar? Like, which of your seminars do you think, or could you build one for that?
Oh, no, it's already done. How to Press Play When You're Stuck on
Pause. So that one would be very appropriate for people who are obviously, that makes sense.
You can come to the website and check that out.
Because
it breaks down into, I'll just answer.
Yeah, sure. Yeah,
it breaks down into different topics. There's topics about seeing the silver lining in career transitions.
Right.
The bright side of career transitions. So that's obviously speaks for itself.
Right.
And then there's another one called Create Positive Energy in the Workplace.
Right.
And that's really, really a popular one.
Okay, so that could be good for companies who are not necessarily laying off people, but just want to improve morale and things like that.
That's a key word there, because one of the things is that, you know, like, people may be really relieved that they weren't laid off, but come on, they're still worried for their job. So, you know, I come in and I just say, you know, I just have everyone learn to be optimistic, because there is a silver lining to every dark cloud they're under. So
Yeah, you're absolutely right, and everything happens for a reason. So, you know, you always have to look for the bright side.
Exactly.
Like you say, you know, if things happen in life and you can use it as an opportunity to learn something, things happen in life. People do get laid off. You know, people do get sick. We're humans.
Yep, absolutely.
And we have great things that happen in our lives, and sometimes bad things are going to happen. And yet, you know, you have to kind of learn to roll with it. And
you brought up something really important, too, is that, you know, that people have gone through difficult times before, and they've always come out of it. So it's to be able to practice thinking and remembering those times when you felt great, because that gets completely wiped out. I mean,
right.
Your self-worth gets wiped out when unexpected change and crisis hits.
Right.
Your self-esteem gets wiped out. So
there
are just simple tools. And I love sharing movies, you know, as a simple tool, because one of my favorites that I'm talking about a lot now is Cinderella Man
with
Russell Crowe. And that was based on a real-life person, a boxer named Jim Braddock, during the Great Depression.
And great movie.
Yeah, and it was filmed here in Toronto. Yeah, it was.
Yeah,
I highly recommend people to see it as a worst-case scenario, because some people are saying, well, you know, that's about the Depression, but it's just like, well, it doesn't matter. Take a look at how this movie hero, who I like to call cinematic role models, had survived with a family, with three kids, for several years, you know, by keeping his passion alive, which was his family. He loved his family. He loved boxing.
Right.
Second, as I talked about, was building relationships. Was he kept a sense of community going, even if it was just his neighborhood.
Right.
And all that builds optimism. And he's just a success story that will stand the test of time.
Okay, well, Emmanuel, you are doing great work. And if
Thank
people
you.
Want to learn more about you, they should check out your website, which is motivatorman.com.
Motivatorman.
From there, they can see the different keynotes and seminars that you have available, you can deliver.
And
they should also check out your blog, Movies That Motivate, and sign up to receive your blog.
Yep.
And they're going to learn more about you in weeks to come. We're going to
talk
more about things that are going on
exactly.
with you.
Yep.